And gunfights like that are the reason why I keep coming back to Tactical Assault. Honestly, there's not another game like it on the market right now, and until we get more news or when a launch date for Geronimo, we're gonna have to keep playing this. And honestly, I'm kind of okay with that. This game's a lot of fun, the tactics you can use very similar to real life, and playing with friends in multiplayer is something to be had in this game. So with that out of the way, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. As you can see, we're playing more Tactical Assault, and this time I'm playing on the map Solid Snake, which is one of the newer maps that they added in an update not too long ago. And if you're curious of my loadout, I'm actually running the MCX Spear, the Heckler & Koch 45 caliber pistol, some breaching charges, flashbangs into round it off. I believe I'm running the sledgehammer as well. You know, really just trying to mix it up with this loadout and trying to challenge myself while going into this raid solo. And as you can see from the carnage off the start, you know, it's already getting pretty crazy. So if you haven't played this map or not familiar with the objectives, you're tasked with finding a high value target, taking them out and extracting. But the catch is there's like 6 or 7 buildings on this map, lots of CQB as you can see here, checking my corners, and you know, as you can probably see as well, I have no teammates, so I'm rocking this solo. I am solo on this mission. I am kind of taking my time, checking corners, trying not to move too quickly on this. But you'll see here, I definitely get shot at by a number of NPCs, and it gets pretty hectic. And honestly, one of the best parts about this map is all the angles that you can't cover. It's literally a kill box when you're going in between these buildings. You'll see here, I'm breaching in these houses, and you know, the NPCs, they don't hold back. The AI will absolutely murder you if you make a wrong move. So jumping into the gameplay, I'm kind of making my way through the houses, trying to find the target, getting shot at, trying to recover. You can see right here, I'm actually looking to see if I have the health pens, because I actually took some shots and I was running low on health, so I was like, ah, okay. But trying to carefully maneuver through and not get myself killed. I think I only gave myself 1 life to run through this, and if I died, I'd only get 1 more respawn essentially. So that's kind of the challenge here, what I'm going for today. And it was honestly a tough one. So again, the CQB nature of this map is really the whole appeal of it. And you're able to use different tactics, your breaching charges, your flashbangs, sledgehammers to clear. I mean, look at this alleyway. Look at all these corners you have to cover. It's not possible in real life to do this, but obviously it's a video game. Again, trying to methodically navigate throughout this city, and honestly, it's kind of tough. The first few times you can get lost, and you know, looking for that target, trying to find what building they're in, and it's just, it's kind of crazy. There's plenty of corners and plenty of angles to get shot and killed, so it definitely gives a thrill when you're playing this, especially solo. And you'll see here, actually running the 45, some guy tries to run up behind me, take him out. And I think that's the other crazy thing, like the AI, they'll actually hunt you down, especially when you kill the HVT. I know they come and like will try and triangulate your position and kill you, but like even without that, they come after you, and especially solo, you don't have somebody watching your back, so it makes it a little bit more difficult. So you'll see here, I actually hear a door open behind me and an NPC's chasing me. So I drop him, and that's the other thing I forgot to mention. The NPCs will actually open doors in this game, and you know, you'll kind of hear it all around you. You'll see here, I have to take the mask off the guy because we're trying to identify the HVT and make sure it's the right target. You can see here, I'm actually struggling to open the door. For some reason, he was blocking it, so I just decided to pull out the sledgehammer and just smash it open. I don't know what's up with that bug, but it's all good. So again, making my way out into the open, into the alley, making sure I'm not getting flanked anywhere, doing the best I can just to navigate through. And you'll see here, the structure ahead, there's a lot of kill spots, a lot of angles, and you know, just trying to do my best to navigate around and trying to listen for footsteps or just anything that can help me get the tactical edge. And you'll notice too, I'm kind of hugging the walls And that's more so just for a tactical advantage, just because I'm trying to make myself as small as possible when playing this game and utilizing cover wherever possible, peeping my head around and not my full body, just so that line of sight isn't as clear for the enemy, just because they're so deadly and can one-tap you on occasion. So you'll see here, I'm just kind of checking around on these streets and doing my best to cover all the angles. Really, I don't think there's a game that simulates that milsim quite like this on the market right now, and really, that's the whole appeal of this game, is just how realistic. Obviously, the graphics aren't realistic, but, you know, the movement mechanics, the breaching, the guns, you know, it's one of the probably the best VR shooters you can play in terms of single player and just AI campaign-ish. What I mean by that is the replayability factor of this game is really high, and I think for a lot of VR games that's a bit of a struggle, because sometimes you can pick up a game, play it a few times, and kind of forget about it. But at least with this game, you know, you can team up, go by yourself, go solo, and really that's why I keep coming back to this, is, you know, the thrill, the milsim aspect, and, you know, the guns, and as well as the updates. But as you can see here, kind of making my way out back onto the streets, searching for a different building to go locate the HVT, and obviously I'm on the first floor here, checking those corners and just doing my best to locate the target, as well as, you know, keeping myself alive, just because it's such a deadly game. But here I am making my way through the first floor, searching, not seeing anything, just trying to keep tactical, not trying to make any sudden movements, because I know I'm close to the end. I've searched most of the buildings around and I haven't found anything, so just trying to stay alive. This was actually one of the, like, few recordings I did, because I had died a few other times, so really trying to pull this off. You'll see here, I see a guy's feet. Steps. I have no idea what the heck he was doing, but really unfortunate for him. So making my way through, changing mags, I know that the HVT is probably in this building. So I had one breaching charge left, and I figured I'd use it here because there's a good chance he's behind this door. Honestly, I don't know what the heck he was shooting at, but we finally found the HVT, and that kind of kicks off the extraction part of this mission. So essentially, I have to make it all the way back to the location in which I spawned, and a helicopter comes and picks you up. But in the meantime, I know the enemy is going to be getting to my position, so I'm trying to hustle out of here. A close encounter. You'll see I almost died there, so pretty much on my last mag for my AR, and I ran out of ammo with my pistol. So again, I can see the extraction right down there, and finally I can see the guy on the turret coming in, and I end up dying right at the very end. Ultimately, I did make it to the end of the round. I had one respawn remaining, and, you know, I get to the extraction point. You can see the technical rolling in and take him out, and pretty much extracting here. But ultimately, I failed this challenge, and I tried my hardest to make it through without dying one time, but you know, that didn't work out, and unfortunately it happened right at the very end. So I have a theory that the enemies get more aggressive as the round comes to a conclusion. Ultimately, if you made it this far in the video, thank you so much for watching. Feel free to subscribe below and comment below what you want to see next. Do you want to see more Tactical Assault? Have me check out another game. Definitely interested in what you guys want to see. But with that, ladies and gentlemen, this has been Sir Whiskey. Have a great rest of your day, and we'll see you in the next one.